said unto the Lord, Lord God, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. Make a standing unto the Lord. Lord God, we give you praise for how you brought us through many things to stay in us. Oh God, we give you glory. And you help us. Lord, hallelujah. Yeah, God, we give you glory for bringing us safely through the highways and the byways. Through many dangers, seen and unseen. Oh God, we've already come. Oh God, your grace has brought us safe thus far. And your grace leads us on. Oh God, bless us in this service on today. Minister to our needs. God, give us the desires of our heart according to your righteous will. Oh God, we've come to remember your death, your burial, and your resurrection. God, help us to understand. Oh God, what you've done on our behalf. But we're going to give you perpetual praise. We're going to give you glory. We're going to give you honor. Oh God, we thank you for salvation. God, we thank you for comprehension. Lord, and we're saved to the utmost. Oh God, we're saved beyond anything that might hinder us. Oh God, help us today. We're going to give you perpetual praise. And everybody know it's already done. Come on, give God your best praise. Hallelujah. 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 Remain standing for our scripture. We declare this year as the year of the ask. Everybody sing with me, ask for more. In 2024. Hallelujah. As we look at amen, our thematic scripture comes from Luke chapter number 11, verse 9 and verse 10. Everyone read. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. Verse 10, for everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth. To him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Everybody know God is already open. Give God the best praise. Amen. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Sing, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Our God is worthy, worthy, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Yes, he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. He is good. Yes, he is. You know he's worthy. 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 Is that your testimony this morning? God is worthy. Our God is worthy. Oh, worthy. Come on, one more time, everybody. Oh, give thanks feeling good. Clap your hand on these people and shout with the voice of God. We're calling about a good God. Spite of all the vicissitudes of life, we decree and declare that our God is a good God. And He's good when? All the time. God is good. God is good. God is good. All the time. God is good. Right here we're going to open a praise service that you can tell of the Lord's goodness. Testify of His greatness. Amen. In a public environment, let the whole world know how you feel about your God. Who shall be the first?
Doctor's appointment, hallelujah, and I got a letter back, hallelujah. so much of what he's doing, but how he keeping my children, hallelujah, my grandchildren, hallelujah. He keeping them even though they haven't received God yet. But I'm praying, hallelujah, with all my heart and my mind, that they will get the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Even if I don't be here to see it, I just pray that they do.
Thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Another praise or testimony.
Just keep on praying.
The Lord is not. Just keep on.
Yeah. The doctors are practicing medicine, yeah. And they do it.
praise how he continues to give me guidance and understanding, wisdom and knowledge and action. That was the word of prayer. Pray for us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Heaven and earth is going to do what?
Pass away.
Pass away, but God's word is going to stand. How of his word.
Yes.
Amen. If God said it, it's going to come to pass. Yes. Amen. How many know it's going to come to pass? Yes. Amen. Let me encourage you and say, God said it.
God said
it. And it's going to come to pass. Yes. Come on, clap your hands and give God your best praise. Hallelujah. So shall your barns be filled with plenty, and your presses shall burst out with new wine. It's offering time. Amen. We celebrate an offering because God loves what?
A cheerful giver.
And in this economy, if you got something to give to God, you should be thankful. Come on and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so let's stand to our feet as we look to the Lord in faith. My faith looks up to thee. My faith looks up to thee, thou art a Calvary, Savior, hear now hear me why I pray. Jesus will take all my sins away, singing more than me from this day be holy. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you for this divine opportunity. Lord, to bring unto you a portion of what you have blessed us with. Oh God, bless the gifts. Bless the gifts. God, sanctify them both for the upbuilding of your kingdom. Bless those that desire to give but have not. Oh God, be thankful for the advancement of the kingdom through our faith gift. And we give you praise in advance, glory and honor. Everybody knows already, now come on, say in Jesus' name. Amen. Following the directions of the ushers, beginning at the rear, bring your gifts unto the Lord.
The ones who are on my right, stop from the rear, bring your hand out and unto the Lord.
For he is good, yes, he is good.
Sing, oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, yes, he is good. Y'all looking at me like y'all didn't know y'all was preachers. Huh? What you You don't want to accept what the Bible says. That's my assignment. You are God's creation. How many know you're fearfully and wonderfully made?
Yes.
Come on and say hallelujah. Yes. Oh, I wish I could get some preachers to give God your best praise. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. Ephesians chapter 2 and verse number 10 says, we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which before of old were ordained. In other words, God had you before you knew who you were.
Yes.
How many know God had his mind on you? Amen. The Bible says that amen, in the beginning was the Word. That word in the Greek is logos. It means the express thought of God. He was thinking about you. That just wake me up in the morning. No, God got me on his mind. Hallelujah. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. God had me so much on his mind, he put me on the wake-up list. How many know there's some folk that laid down last night not to arrive today?
Hallelujah.
Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. Anybody glad to be on this morning's wake up list?
Yeah.
And he called me out of darkness into this morning's light. And we give God the praise. Today is a special day. Amen. It is the, amen, first Sunday in the month of November. This is the, amen, beginning of the second month of our holy consecration. Amen. Anybody thank God for 90 days of consecration? Come on and say hallelujah. Anybody give this your prayer and fast? The Bible said there's some kind of opposition, talking about spiritual opposition, that only go forth by prayer and fasting. And in this consecration, amen, we're giving ourselves to the Lord, presenting our bodies as what?
A living sacrifice.
A living sacrifice, not a dead sacrifice. But a living sacrifice. We're saying to the Lord, Lord, I know that you require more of me. And so we make up in our mind to give up something that's in our normal day for Christ. Amen. How many know a sacrifice is something that you have to give up? Come on and say hallelujah. It's not just an ordinary gift, but it's something that you're saying, Lord, I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to eat this. I'm not going to go there. I'm going to just give that up for 90 days to let you know how much I appreciate you. Anybody been blessed by giving up to God? Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say glory. We completed one third of this, amen, journey. We've gone through 30 days. Amen. I'm looking at you. Hallelujah. You look 10 times better. Y'all help me look at somebody. Just look at me in the face and say, you look 10 times better.
Yeah.
You better put it on your face. Tell your face you look 10 times better. That's what happened when the Hebrew boys gave their, amen, commitment to God and sacrifice. They entered into a fasting period and a prayer period. And they just told the rulers, amen, just give us 10 days. Just give us 10 days. Hallelujah. And after 10 days, they were found to be, amen, so much fairer. That means better. So much, amen, encouraged. Amen. I'm telling you, if you give to God, he'll adjust your metabolism. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. Amen. Sometimes through life, our get up has gone. We don't even have the desire to do certain things. Anybody ever been in that, amen, spiritual funk? You just got there, and the things that used to just stir you up don't even seem to stir you up no more. But that's why you got to learn to stir up the gift. I wish I had somebody talking to me. Amen. When you begin to stir up that gift, you give yourself in fasting and prayer. You give yourself in consecration unto the Lord. You say, for God I live, and for God I die. I can tell it's already working because some of y'all have got your get up, and you're not ready to go. You're ready to do something for God. So for the next 60 days, I just believe that miracles, signs, and wonders are going to be your daily bread. Everybody say daily bread.
Yeah.
Come on, say it like you thank God for a miracle every day.
Yeah.
That's what the clock sister saw. I expect the miracle when? I'm dating myself. Y'all don't know who the clock sisters are. Y'all, I expect the miracle every day. God is going to make a way out of no way. He's a miracle worker. Amen. Just tell your neighbor he's a miracle worker. He's a miracle worker. Now, I'm telling you, if you're not happy about Jesus, you might get upset with me. Because I got the happy, happy, and the glad, glad. I ain't got no sad song. Amen. You might be worried about, that's what it must be. They must be worried about who's going to be the next president of these United States of America. Maybe the, amen, polarity that you hear people arguing, some acting like donkeys, others acting like elephants. Maybe that's what you are upset about. But how many thank God he was the lamb slain before the foundation of the world? So get your eyes off the donkeys. Get your eyes off the elephant and thank God for the blood of the Lamb. Come on and say hallelujah. That's what his name is. We remember that he paid a debt that he didn't know. I owe a debt that I could never pay. Now, traditionally, we would have the table prepared. Amen. And during this noon service, we would, amen, observe the Lord's Supper. But this day is a special day. Look at your neighbor and say, this day is special. Amen. So we're going to, amen, observe the Lord's Supper at evening at 6 p.m. Y'all come on back. Amen. And we're going to observe the Lord in two commands or ordinances that he gave to the church. One thing he told the church, he says, I want you to observe my body, which is broken for you. I want you to discern my blood, which was shed for you. But at that same night, before he washed, amen, before he served communion, he washed their feet. Because there were two functions going on. One called the Passover. How many thank God have brought you from the old to the new? Yes. Come on and say hallelujah. And so at the Passover meal, which was of the Hebrew tradition, amen, all of the disciples were there. And as they were there, Jesus introduced a new covenant unto them. And what he said is, one of you that's at the table with me, who dipped his hand in the dish, shall betray me. How many know God knew what you already did? Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. And so he was talking about, amen, Judas. But everyone at the table start inquiring, Lord, is it I? Lord, is it I? Just say to God, Lord, is it me? Is it me? Amen. You see, you worried about the sin of others, but you got to take account for the things you have done. Yeah. That's what this table is all about. We bring all of our failures and our shortcomings, and we give it to God, and he puts it under his blood. Because he said, when I see the blood, I will do. Amen. If I thank God that you're not perfect, but you're forgiven. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands for your forgiveness. But Judas was right there. And when he came to Judas, amen, Judas said, Lord, is it I? And Christ responded, thou said. Yeah. And so God at that time transitioned. Amen. And there were those who were around that didn't know what God was doing. But how many know God is in total control? Amen. And so if you look at John chapter 13, you'll see that Judas got up and left the table where they were. And some of them saying, well, he's going to prepare, amen, for other things because he was the treasurer. Amen. That's why you got to get your mind off of what other folk are doing. I don't care who don't want to, who doesn't, amen, want to be a part. I'm focusing on myself. Do I have a witness in here? Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. And so Jesus said, whatever you're going to do, just go do quickly. So I say, as a prophet in this house, whatever you're going to do, you got to do it quickly. Hallelujah. Judas had already arranged the betrayal of the Lord, and he went out. Amen. And while he was finishing the deal, Jesus got up from the table. Amen. Girded himself with a towel, poured water in the basin, and began to wash the disciples' feet. That's what we're going to do on this second part, beginning the second part of this consecration. Amen. You're going to see me at 6 o'clock, and I'm going to gird myself with a towel, and we shall begin to wash the disciples' feet. Amen. Now, Jesus only had all men there, so all the men going to wash men's feet. Amen. And all the women going to wash women's feet. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. It is symbolic of a humility. I'm saying to the Lord, I'm yours. Everything that I am and everything I'm not. And so Jesus, in his wisdom, even included Judas when he was washing feet, and Judas wasn't even there. How many know when you messed up, God still got a message in your mess up? Because he came to Peter and said to Peter, amen, I'm here to wash your feet. Peter said, Lord, you'll never wash my feet. Hallelujah. Amen. Because Peter looked at him as such a great person. I'm the one that should be washing your feet. Yeah. But you know what the Lord told him? If I wash not your feet, you have no part with me. You are not all clean. He was talking about Jews. He was including him in the family. I want you to know God is including all of us in his plan of salvation. No matter how dirty you feel, no matter how unworthy you feel, God wants to wash your feet. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and give God some praise for him including you. Amen. Even though he was not there, he said we are not all clean. But he washed Peter's feet. He said, if I don't wash your feet, you don't have no part with me. Mm-hmm. And then this is the interesting part. He got up from washing their feet and went right back to the same table. And when he got to the table, which was the Passover table, amen, he broke a new covenant with them. And he said, this is the bread, amen, which is my body, which is broken for you. See, under the Passover meal, that bread represented, amen, the manna that they had in the wilderness. Amen, the blood, the wine that they had represented the blood of bulls and bulls. But thank God, the bread now in the Holy Communion is his broken body, his shed blood, so that you and I can understand the difference between a Hebrew that's in the flesh and somebody that's born of the Spirit. Yes. Anybody glad you've been born again? Everybody that's been born again, give God some glory. Yes. Yes. So Peter, get that out in your Lord and Master. And wash your feet. You ought to wash one another's feet. It's a symbol.
Thank you.
It's a representation. And anything that's trying to get you not to do what God commanded, that's an attack from the enemy. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. And I just want to encourage everybody that can meet me here at 6 o'clock so we can observe the Lord's Supper. It's going to be a closed session because once they were in God's presence, nobody was able to go come in unless Jesus allowed, amen, Judas to go out. Hallelujah. And so we're going to be in a prayerful position, showing humility one to another. Amen. Showing our love one to another. Somebody thank God for his word. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. I told you this kind of day consecration, there are going to be a few things we're going to do. One of them is going to be the washing of feet. I still don't have the date as of yet. Amen. Because I just don't pick a date on the calendar. I ask God for that day. Amen. He hasn't given it to me. We're going to enter into an all-night prayer. Somebody say, Jesus prayed all night.
Jesus prayed all night.
How about you?
How about you?
All right, I'm going to show you how easy it is to get twisted. How many ever had a problem that kept you up all night?
Yes, Lord.
Huh? Yeah. You wanted to go to sleep, but couldn't go to sleep. Huh?
Amen.
Even babies, young children, sometimes cry all night long. It's something that has disturbed They're sleep paralyzed. So you gonna sit here and act like you haven't been awake all night because of something that has challenged your humanity? But I want you to know, if Jesus can pray all night, you can pray all night. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say glory. Hallelujah. So we're going to have an all night command. That's going to be, amen, one thing they're going to do. And then the final part, on the 31st of December, as we come off this consecration, we're going to bring God a sacrificial offering. We're not going to offer it until the first praise of the new year. But we're going to pray 24 out and pray 25 in. And then we're going to offer God an offering of sacrifice. So right now, in your mind and in your heart, I want you to start thinking of what it is you want to give to the Lord. God doesn't put no amount on an offering, but the Bible says, as you have been prospered, I should allow you to give. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. How many know there's no big amount to God? Because he's greater than anything you can give to him.
Yeah.
There's no small amount to God. Because if it comes from your heart, it's more than all them folk who gave more, and it didn't come from their heart. So three parts that I'm telling you in this consecration that I want you to participate in. Hallelujah. I want you to participate in giving to the Lord. Sacrifice and offerings, Holy Communion, and feet washing. And see what God does for us in the beginning of 2025. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, it's already done. It's
already done.
Amen. 2024, we decree that the year of the ask. A-S-K. Asking, seeking, knocking.
Yes, yes.
Everybody say ask.
Ask.
Asking.
Asking.
Seeking.
Seeking.
Knocking. All right, stay with me. The Bible says in Luke chapter 11, verse 9 and 10, hallelujah, and I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you.
Yes.
Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be what?
Open
unto you. Amen. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be open. Today I want to talk to you about redeeming time. Redeeming the time. Everybody say redeem the time. Redeem. Amen. Hallelujah. Now I'm going to show you about time manipulation. How many know today is what they call daylight saving time? Look at your neighbor and say, it's later than you think. It's
later.
Now according to, amen, the Greenland timekeeper, it's 12:46. In the 8:09 p.m. Now, according to the official timekeeper that's in Greenland, it's 12:46. Amen. But how many realize that there are different time zones throughout the world? I just want you to put your mind to this. Some Americans got together and decided that for labor reasons, because we want y'all to work while it is day, we're going to manipulate the time. Look at your neighbor and say, it's later than you think. It's late. It's later than you think. Now, if that is the case, then you should be one less hour older than you are. You should be.
1 hour
less. Because at 1:59 this morning, they stopped time for a whole 60 minutes, and then they started it again.
That's crazy.
Huh? And they call it daylight what? And the reason they do this is because God's time is dependent upon things that we can see. And so, how many realize that this earth rotates on an axis and it rotates around the sun? Oh, come on now. Y'all ain't anybody ever started. Y'all made some planets and all that stuff like that. Do I have that right? Huh? And so based on where we can see the sun,
That's what determines the day and the night. But if you believe the Bible says the evening and the morning were the first day. In other words, it didn't start like the Roman calendar tells you it starts at midnight. It actually starts at 6 p.m. That's how come we're going to come at evening.
Come on and say hallelujah.
That's why we're going to come. When we are engaged in this communion and feet washing, it's actually the beginning of a new day.
Yes, Lord.
Look at your neighbor and say, I thank God for a new day. I thank God for a new day. Redeeming the time. A man got a manipulation. Going to make you feel like because he stopped the clock that he can stop time. In the book of Joshua, chapter number 10, we do see where God stopped the sun so that Joshua could get the victory. When you are in need of the victory, no matter what manipulation man has done, God can stop time to allow you to cross over. Somebody thank God that he's that good of a God. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say hallelujah. Redeeming. In Ephesians chapter 5, verse 15 and 16, the Bible says, see then that ye walk, everybody read, circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. What? Redeeming the time because. Oh, look at your neighbor and say, the days are evil. The days are evil. Amen. Y'all know I keep up. Amen. Much as I can with the murder rate here in New Haven, especially in Fairhaven.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And I have a notification that comes every time somebody is murdered. Because every time somebody is murdered, I want to give God glory and praise that he didn't let nobody connected to this church. Amen. God. Come on and say hallelujah. Because I already prophesied, you shall and not die. Look at your neighbor and say, you're going to live and not die. You're going to live and not die. Hallelujah. Amen. And I believe God.
Yes.
And I trust him. I can't explain why other things happen. And I don't really understand why it's such a rampant murder rate in such a small little area. But I thank God for the blood. I thank God for his divine covering. And I give him praise in advance. Somebody thank God he's keeping you alive. Come on, thank God he's keeping you alive. Hallelujah. Bullets flying everywhere. Sometimes it just gets so depressing when I read through what caused the murder. Sometimes just simple misunderstanding. A lot of times, misidentity. Amen. Have a beef with somebody and go to the wrong house. It's the house next door. And then shoot up everybody in the house. Exactly. Amen. How many know you're glad that God protected your house? Wherever you live in right now, you just call your address and give God some praise for protecting your address right now. Open up your mouth and give God your address and thank him for taking care of your address right where you live. Give God some praise. Amen. Thousands of miles to get here. Amen. This place is on my mind. Hallelujah. Because I know this is a place that God has ordained for the deliverance of his people. And so God said, God protect, God watch over. Let no hurt, no harm, no danger. Even I thank God for a refuge. The Lord is my refuge. He's my fortress. He's my God. That's what I've been doing. I've been redeeming the time. Somebody that knows you can redeem the time by praying for your house, by praying for your neighborhood, by praying for your situation. For God can stop time in a bullet pass by. God can stop time in the accident that you really got in. He'll stop you from getting in that accident. God will stop time and disease that should have wrecked your body. It'll pass you by. It might thank God that he stopped so that you can be delivered. Thank you. amen, that God has kept you alive. Hallelujah. You can just look at your own situation and realize that there's some things that you should have been dead. Hallelujah. But the Lord has kept you alive. Come on and say, redeem the time. Redeem the time. If you don't learn to redeem the time, the Bible says you're walking as a fool. If you don't learn to redeem the time, you are just like, amen, green now. Dead man walking. Look at your neighbor, say, dead man walking. Dead. Amen. We all were born in sin. And Satan in iniquity. Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 27 puts it like this. It's appointed unto man once to die. And after that, there's going to be a judgment. Don't fool yourself. I don't care, amen, what they try to come up scientifically. Amen. Back in the 50s, they came up with this, amen, another manipulation of time. Amen. They would put folk in an environment that would freeze themselves. Don't you know there's some folk who are frozen right now, waiting for the solution to the thing that was ravaging their body, waiting for that to be discovered, and then according to their will, amen, they're supposed to try to unfreeze them and so that they can live on. But how many realize no matter what the world say, you gonna die? Come on and say hallelujah. I don't care if they put you in a cold environment, they lock you up, and then they say you're still living, but you dead. Dead in your trespasses and sin. Why? Because you got hope in the wisdom of man and not in the works of God. How many know why you was trying to figure it out? God has already worked it out. If you know God has already worked it out, give God some glory. Walk circumspectly. That means with a panoramic view.
Yes.
Now
yes.
I know it's going to be challenging for some of you. Hallelujah. But I want you to be obedient. I want everybody to stand on your feet. Amen. And I want you to take a panoramic view. I want you to take a slow turnaround. Right where you are, just turn around. And then I want you to say with me, every time I turn around, the Lord keep blessing me. Every time I turn around, the Lord keep blessing me. Do it at the beginning. Every time I turn around, the Lord keep blessing me. And if you know the Lord is blessing you, clap your hands and give him a turn around prayer. You can be seated. I want you to know this. In every aspect, there's evil on your right hand, there's evil on your left hand, there's evil in front of you, there's evil behind you, there's evil above you, there's evil beneath you, because we're living in an evil and fallen world. But I'm so glad greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world. So it doesn't matter where I go, I'm going to walk circumspectly. I'm going to thank God for blessings on my right hand. I thank God for blessings on my left hand. I thank God for blessings that are behind me. I thank God for blessings ahead of me. How many realize that when you woke up in the morning, God already had a blessing for you? And then before you lay down tonight, you're going to lay down in a blessing. I wish I could get somebody to pray God no matter how evil the days are. Testify that my God is a good God. And he's good all the time. He's good all the time. And that folks trying to get you sociologically locked up, amen, into what they call a black card experience. Amen. They'll just go around and they'll say to other races and nationalities, amen, finish this statement, God is good. And it's amazing to me how the other folk don't know that God is good. All the time. And they try to make that a black thing. But how many know it's not just a black thing? I don't know God being good because of the melanin in my skin. I know God being good because of salvation that's in my soul. Somebody that got a salvation in your soul. Do what the psalmist said in Psalm 103. Bless the Lord. Oh my soul. And all that. I wish I could get somebody to give them a real soul praise. Hallelujah. You got to redeem the time. Some folk arguing over what color Jesus is. They argue so much that they want to be a chosen people that God used. Amen. I'm not going to get into no deep argument. You can be a Hebrew Israelite. You can be an Israelite Hebrew. You can be whatever you want to be. But let me explain something to you. When God made Adam out of the dust of the ground, amen, he didn't have no nationality, no race, amen, other than the human race. And when you understand what hue is, amen, it's a dark, thick soil. Come on and say hallelujah. And within that soil is every color. Hallelujah. That's why I told you on yesterday, you are becoming. In other words, out of the soil he made man. But when he got ready to make woman, because man cannot reproduce himself without the help of a woman, he didn't take the woman out of the soil, but he took the woman out of the man. That's why you got to learn to redeem the time. Amen. Woman, I don't care what they say. Don't go fighting trying to be a man. You just be a woman. You be the one that God is going to bring the deliverer out of.
You know about that water, hallelujah.
And then, so when I see women out in the street, I can be in a Come on and say hallelujah. God bless them. Hallelujah. Their ankles might be swollen. Their back might be hurting. But if they understand the plan of God, they'll thank God for life on the inside. And every now and then that baby starts kicking. Let me explain something to you. In prayer, I saw straightway with that wall. I saw straightway just rocking from side to side. In my prayer, I could see the kicking going on. How do you know God is doing something in this sanctuary? How do you know God is doing something in this house? And that's when you got to redeem this house. Hallelujah. It takes about 40 weeks for a woman to bring forth a child. But how do you realize when they say it's going to happen, it will always happen at the right time. I wish I could get somebody to testify. How do you know you are an early born child? They said you were going to come on this day, but you came a little bit early. Is there anybody that came early? Anybody that came premature? Anybody that came unexpected? Lord, give God a praise and say, I'm here. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say glory. Hallelujah, my last two children. The date that man said, they arrived before that day. But my first child, he arrived after the day. And then I can just remember. Hallelujah. I said to my wife, hallelujah. I don't know if the doctor's got it wrong, but we're going to take a walk. I believe that's why I look at that wall. Hallelujah. We was in Waterford, Connecticut. Hallelujah. We just walked around the complex. And then it actually began to walk. I was taking care of my firstborn child. And then just like I see you walking, you might come than I expect. And you might come earlier than I expect. But I know you're going to get here. God is bringing your sons. He's bringing your daughters. He's bringing your children. He's bringing your neighbors. And boy, I'm going to redeem the time. How do you redeem the time? I'm going to praise God in advance. Somebody give God a praise. Come on, you know God got it this time. Come on and say glory. But I learned to walk in wisdom. Colossians 4 and verse 5. It said, walk in wisdom toward them that are without. In other words, they might not be here, but I got enough knowledge to know if God promised me, it's going to happen. Look at the neighbor and say, it's going to happen. Just like he said it would. Oh, y'all ain't talking to nobody. It's going to happen. Just like he said it would. In these last days, as a modern-day prophetess, as a modern-day prophet, God told the church, and then through the mouth of Peter, on this day called Pentecost, that in the last days, I'm going to pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Do I have any flesh in here? Somebody thank God for the spirit that's in your flesh. The spirit that's on your flesh. The spirit that's in your mouth. I'm going to get somebody to thank God for the power to prophesy. Come on and say glory. And it shall come to pass. Everyone that asks, you will receive. Everyone that seeks, they want to find. And everyone that knocks, the door shall be opened unto you. This is the year that you can ask God. The days are evil, but I'm walking in wisdom. Look at the neighbor and say, I'm wiser now. Hallelujah. 2024 brought a lot of stuff. Amen. But I'm wiser because of it. Amen. I had a little setback, but I'm wiser because of it. Amen. I had some trials and tribulations, but I'm wiser because of it. Y'all heard my wife testify. Hallelujah. But I thank God that she learned. Sometimes we get so caught up and rely on the wisdom of men. But I know the wisdom of God is greater than the wisdom of men. If you ever have to go to the hospital physician. If you're sick, the Bible says call for the elders. If you're sick, let us anoint you with oil, and the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. And if you do that, and you still got to go to the hospital, go in the hospital and say, I'm healed. Go in the hospital and say, I'm delivered. Go in the hospital and say, I'm set free. Because when the doctor tries to tell you anything that's inconsistent with what God said, you can reject it. Come on and say, hallelujah. You can tell me I ain't going to do that. Under here say, well, this is my class. But I already heard from the Lord. He told me that he was wounded for my transgression. He was bruised for my iniquity. The chastisement of my peace is upon him. Somebody say, by his stripes.
Your name in the Lamb's book of life. Come on and say hallelujah.
you God's man. It don't matter if you're black or white. All that stuff will go in the dumps. But there's going to be a trump of God that's going to sound. And the dead in Christ, when you get up out of the grave, you ain't going to have no flesh. Not from this earth. But God got a heavenly body. Come on and say hallelujah. The things I used to do, I don't do them no more. Then they go a little further. I could understand that because I'm a child. But what I couldn't understand, they say, I looked at my hands, and my hands looked new. Come on, somebody look at your hands. And thank God for new hands. What they were talking about, I didn't understand it then. But when I got in prayer, God said he'll give you a vision of your new body. He'll give you a vision of your new presence. Anybody glad when you look at your hands? You're not looking at the flesh, but you're looking at the spirit. Somebody that got new hands, you've got a new praise. Somebody that got a new mouth, you've got a new crown. Come on and say it. Is a gift from God.
Yes.
And none of us know how much we are like. Somebody say, redeem the time. Come on, say it like a Pentecostal. Look at the neighbor and say, redeem the time. Come on and say hallelujah. They taught me a song, something like this. Time is filled with swift transition. None on earth a move can stand. You can build your hopes on things eternal. Anybody can finish that for me. Oh, the God's one changing hand. Somebody lift your hand to God and say, I got you, God. Come on and say hallelujah. Yeah, God knows. Amen. Each of us, how much time he could just each of us have. Amen. The time he gave you is to make the right choice. Somebody say, make the right choice. Now, I am not talking politically, but I want you to know that whenever somebody trying to force you to do something against your own choice, that don't come from God. But God give every man a choice. Look at the neighbor and say, I choose to live right. Come on and say glory. Amen. So I'm pro-choice. You say you pro-life, but I'm pro-choice. Because if I don't choose Jesus, I never know how to live. But as long as I got King Jesus, everything is going to be all right. I wish I could get somebody to help me preach. And say, right on, King Jesus. Right on. I can see my King. I can see him coming. And then to my rescue. Before you even pray, days of our years? 3 score years and 10. Come on and say hallelujah. Everybody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everybody that's under the age of 10, 10 and under, if you're in this building, I want everybody that's 10 and under, I want you to stand on your feet. Just be only two, be 3 people. Come on, stand up right now. Everybody that's 10 and under. 2, 3, 4. How are you guys?
10.
10, all right.
10 and under.
How are you guys, brother?
9.
You got to tell me how old you are. Come on. All right. What's your name? I forget your name now.
Jay.
Jay.
Yes,
I
got your name.
No, I got Jay. What's your name?
Tyrone.
Tyrone. Everybody say, God bless Tyrone. Everybody. Come on, right now. Say it like you really mean it. Repeat the title. Come on, pray for Tyrone right now. Pray for Tyrone right now. In the name of Jesus. Come on, say hallelujah. Amen. Jay. Everybody say, God bless Jay. God bless Jay. I told y'all. Amen, about me and how I deal with those that bring forth life. I think that's why I call her eyes. Amen, because the first time I laid eyes on her, I could see hope in her soul. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. Amen, she got a wonderful, amen, way of trusting people. And that can cause damage because she'll be looking for the right thing. But the wrong thing can happen. But I curse that right now. Jesus. Somebody stretch your hands toward Jane. And say to the Lord, cover her and protect her. But the answer is in her decision. When she make up in her mind, I'm going to follow Jesus. Now thank God for Tyler following Jesus. Thank God for Jay following Jesus. Somebody thank God for 5 generations. Come on and say hallelujah. I'm telling y'all, I ain't this smart. But I'm telling you what God will do for this day. He brought Tylon and Jane here this day because I wanted to explain something to you. The Bible says the days of our years, amen, Sister Sarah Natalie, are 3 score years and 10. That means 70 years. Come on and say hallelujah.
I'm not saying that God is not with your family, but I'm trying to redeem the time.
hallelujah. See, them two over there come from a different, they come from my Florida days. They don't come from my Connecticut days. I'm still walking with you. Come on and say hallelujah. Look at the neighbor and say, lean this way. Lean this way. Hallelujah. Amen. See, amen. That little bitch right there. Hallelujah. You see Sister Weaver? Hallelujah. Is that Junior's daughter?
Brian's daughter.
What's your name?
Sage.
Sage. And what's your name? No, where's the other one?
She's not. It's the right one. This is Scott.
I thought it was two.
No, just. Oh, he's the.
Okay, go. Now, Skyler, you're born in 10, right?
She didn't say
that. Okay, I was going to say it's one. All right. Because you kind of scooped down. That's what got me. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody thank God for Sage. Come on. Come on, thank God for Sage. Hallelujah. But y'all know the story. Hallelujah. The largest church, largest family that was in our church in Orlando. Amen. Sister Weaver's great-grandmama.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I baptized her when she was 77 years of age. Look at your neighbor and say, it's never too late. It's never too late. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. And then all night prayer. Somebody say all night prayer. All night. Amen. Hallelujah. Sister Weaver, I affectionately call her Courtney. Because I remember she was a little girl. And she could tell you. Amen. I would ask she would come as a little girl. I'd lay hands on her and tell you special. That you're going to be a lion leader. There's an anointing on your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Now she's a school teacher. Amen. She's leading folks. The whole family. They can't do nothing. They said, we waiting on Courtney. I said, Courtney in New York. Come on and say hallelujah. But when God got a job for you, somebody need to give God some praise. Come on and say, give God some glory. Hallelujah. And so, amen, her grandmother would stand up. Hallelujah. Mother Iris, Lord, in all night prayer. Because we break bread up and give people at a period of time. Amen. To either tell what it is that they have been inspired of God. Or what they want to put in the atmosphere. And I'm telling you, this stuff works. All you got to do is speak it in the atmosphere. Somebody want to tell God, amen, put it in the atmosphere. Ask and ye shall receive. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. Somebody give God some praise and say glory. Hallelujah. And so Mother Iris, Lord, would stand. She wasn't an outgoing person. She was a real quiet person, but a very wise person. And she spoke with a quiet tone. But she would say something like this, Lord, I want you to bless my children. I want you to bless my family. God, I want them to come in. And now from one person, they grew to be the largest family that came into the church. Hallelujah, the family and friends day. Come on and say hallelujah. And y'all know what our family and friends, they might be a little late, but they come from the rocks. But when they come in, they have to come all over the place. If God give you somebody, if he give you a family, you got to give God the praise straightway. I want you to know God is blessing your family straightway. Y'all ever see that? They ain't no them 8-inch stilettos, but with a 2-inch, amen, pop. Come on and say hallelujah. God is a good God.
That's good.
82?
Yes, he is.
5 generations of children in the house of God. Come walking in, and she just did it. If you see her, she got a little step. She come walk in like that. Hallelujah. Amen. God is a good God. Because I know this is just the beginning. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right. Strength, labor, and sorrow. For the soon be cut off and we what?
Fly away.
You know the power of thy anger, even according to thy fear, nor is thy wrath. I'm about to let you go. This is what I'm trying to say, redeem the time. Somebody say, teach me.
Teach me.
Come on, say, teach me.
Teach me.
To number my days.
To number my days.
Everybody stand on your feet. Lord, teach us to number our days that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Remember I told you how to walk circumspectly, redeem the time, because of what? Days are evil. I want you to stand because I want you to hear what I'm saying. Every year I seek God for the consecration for a word for the new year. Ever since I've been here, you see me put up banners to remind you what God put in my spirit in prayer. This year, he didn't give me a word as of yet. But what he did is tell me that it is worse than you think. Look at the neighbor and say, it's worse than you think.
It's worse than you think.
Come on, look at another person and tell them. Say, God said it's worse.
God said it's worse
than you think.
Amen.
Amen. How many deal with a chronic illness, a sickness right now? In your body, right? Hallelujah. If you know your heart, get chronic. It just won't go away. It's been there. Amen. I'm trying to tell you about the prophet of God. It's worse than you think.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That thing should have took you out. Hallelujah. But God got you here to give him the glory. God got you here to give him the praise. God keeping you alive. Come on and say hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
And when she knew she couldn't deny, I come to tell you, through the word of God, God has already done what you need. He's already answered your request. Why? Because you feel his virtue. Anybody feel the truth of God on that side? Anybody feel the power of God on that side? Well, give God a powerful praise. Give God some glory. Teach us to number our days. I want you to go another day and you don't thank God for what he already done. For what he already done. I want you to know he's already healed you. And you got to give him the glory for your healing. Come on and say hallelujah. She couldn't deny no more.
Yes.
Her oldness. You remember her request that month for healing? She said, if I but touch the hem of his garment, I'll be made. Y'all see the difference between healing and wholeness? Your wholeness got to come when you admit that nobody but Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
Nobody but the Lord. You know why she didn't walk? Nobody recognized her? Because of her condition. She had a bleeding condition. At that time, you couldn't even be around people. But she made up in her mind, with my bloody self, I'm going to touch the hell of his God. Amen. Yeah. With my problem, I'm going to grab hold to the Lord. And the moment she grabbed hold to the Lord, her blood stopped. Her soul began to be saved. The moment she grabbed hold to God, her blood stopped, but she needed to be saved. God didn't just come to heal you. He come to save your soul. Is anybody thank God for salvation? Is anybody thank God for salvation? I'm wise enough to know I don't want to die and go to hell. Are you looking at the prophet of man? You gave the whole world. You get your healing, but you still die and go to hell. I want to be whole. I want to be made whole. I want to be made whole. Is there anybody beside me want to be made whole today? It's later than you think. That's what the Lord told me. I don't know words he's going to put on. He don't put no words on it. Then I'm just going to tell you. Amen. It's later is worse than you think. Well, God told me that so much is going to happen in 2025. He said, get the people ready for it. Get the people ready. 2019, 2020, 2021 were only an inkling of the end times. Mm-hmm. Come on and say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Anybody know something cold, the worst that COVID is coming in? Anybody realize COVID is still here?
Yes.
Hallelujah. There's unrest in the Middle East. There's unrest all throughout Europe. There's trouble. I told you all about the murders that's right here in your neighborhood.
Yes.
It's worse than you think.
Mm-hmm.
To teach us to know our days.
Thank you, Jesus.
Acts 17:26 puts it like this. We made one blood of all nations of men, for to dwell on earth, in the face of earth, and have determined the times. Everybody say, determine the times.
Determine the times.
Before appointed, and the bounds of their habitation. In other words, I want you to say, just say with me, when God says we should be redeeming the time,
God says we should be redeeming the time,
he wants us to live in.
He wants us to live in.
Now I want you to put what he wants you to live in. Everyone stand up with me. What does he want you to live in? You got to be wise enough to know what he wants you to live in. What he wants you to live in? You be wise enough to understand what your purpose is.
Living
him. Living him. Hallelujah. Can you be more specific? Where he wants you to live in him at? Ask. Seek. Knock. God is giving you the ability to tell him what it is you want to live in. Hallelujah.
Most of the church, I want to live in wealth. I just want stuff. You know what I want to live in? I want to live in a house where everybody in my house say, everybody in my house. I want to live in a neighborhood where everybody in the neighborhood speaking in tongues. The Spirit of God gets on us. You know what I want to live in? I want to live in an organization where everybody is following the truth of God. And nobody is reserving. And everybody has a loving heart and a loving mind. A loving understanding. Anybody want to tell God for what you want to live in? Come on right now. Tell him what you want to live in. Tell him what you want to live in. Tell him what you want to live in. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. God, let's go. Father, we need God, I share a portion of what you've given unto me to share with them. To encourage them to redeem your time. Because the days are evil. Bless them, God, as they depart from this place. But never from your presence. When we come back at 6 p.m., God, we're coming, Lord, to lay aside every weight and the sin that does so easily beset us. God, help us, and we want to be helped. Strengthen us, and we shall be strengthened. And we'll give you glory and praise in Jesus' name. Everybody know it's already done. Lift your right hand to the Lord. Gently wave it in the air and just tell him thank you.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name. Now I want you to take that same right hand of thanksgiving, and I want you to lay it on your chest and say, I am made whole. I am made whole. According to your faith. According to your faith. According to your faith. According to your faith.
Yeah,
you call for the elders. That's what the Bible says, if any sick among you. Hallelujah. But I want you to know you can pray for your own self. If it is afflicted among you, the Bible says, let him pray. One more time. Take that right hand. Put it on your chest and say, I am made whole. I am made whole. Every affliction, everything that's fighting against you, everything that's trying to hinder you, everything that's trying to stop you. Amen. Come on, put your right hand over your chest and you pledge allegiance to your God right now. And say to God, I'm yours. I am yours. Come on, pledge allegiance to your God right now. And say in sickness and in health. Come on, pledge allegiance to your God. And say, I am yours. Come on, pledge allegiance to your God. And say, you can count on me. Now clap your hands and give God some praise. Hallelujah. Kindness. I know we went a little longer than I anticipated. Amen. Just be reminded. Now, for those who are auxiliary heads, make sure that we get your information as far as reporting, because our holy convocation will be here on next weekend, Friday and Saturday.